So I've got quite a few pickups to show you guys from, I want to say, the past 2 weeks, maybe. All the videos that you've been seeing lately have been from, like, 2 weeks ago, for the most part. I just pretty much filmed all of them at once and then didn't film anything for like 2 weeks and just kept gradually uploading them. I've got quite a few things, not really as much as like some people would get, but yesterday was my 6th day out of 6 working in a row, and that's usually, I spend a lot of time at work, so I'm not always able to do videos, and then when I get home, I've got other things I've got to do, so. Some of these are going to be from when I was in Kansas for my sister's birthday. First things first, though, I've got a package from Power Player Paul on YouTube. He messaged me, I want to say probably about a week ago, asking me if I would like some cables for the original Xbox, because I did find one in the dumpster quite a long time ago, but I never got around to testing it because I don't have the cables for it. And so just out of nowhere, he asked me if I would like some. He found some, and he was just going to send them to me. So that's awesome. So pretty much that's what we got here. So now I can play the games that I've been wanting to play that are not compatible with Xbox 360, which I'm starting to come across lately. So there's like about, I want to say, 450 games that are backwards compatible, but there are some of them that aren't. I've got a note here, too, it looks like. Says, "Hey Cassie, I was able to test out these cables and they work perfectly. I hope these will help you help to get your Xbox running so you can experience awesome original Xbox games like that Knights of the Old Republic 2 you just picked up. I look forward to seeing your Xbox collection grow. Keep up the great work. Sincerely, Paul, aka Power Player Paul." Well, thank you, Paul. I'll probably have to send something back to you also for being so nice. My Xbox is actually, it's in storage right now. And if you want to look outside here, I'm not going out today. Not going anywhere today. I don't like driving in the snow. It sucks. My car sucks in the snow. I've got a 2007 Chevy Cobalt, and yeah, it's not the best. So here's to the pickups. This is actually something I picked up yesterday. Speaking of Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic, I know that one's actually the second one. Is a backwards compatible game for the Xbox 360, but I'm not sure about the first. I haven't looked it up yet, but I did happen to find this at Disc Replay yesterday. I hardly ever see two, but I've never seen the first one before there. But someone just happened to go up to the counter while I was there looking at the Super Nintendo games, and he asked them if they had the first one. And he looked it up in his computer, and none of them were actually out on the sales floor. They were all back behind, not out yet. So, and he said he had several of them. So right after he asked, I was like, "You said you had several of them. Do you have another copy? Because I would like that one too." And so they gave me this. There's the registration is in here. There's no manual, though, but neither did his have it, so... It was $12, but I never, and yes, it's Platinum Hits, but I never, Platinum Hits was the only one they had, so happy to get that, because I've never played any of the Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic games, because I never had an original Xbox, so I'm happy to get that, and I'm excited to play those. So I love Star Wars, so. Also picked up this. Not really sure how good of a game it is, but I always remember seeing stuff for this, like, everywhere. But it's Dragon Slayer. And it might be a terrible game, I'm not really sure. I just remember always seeing stuff for this. Like, I don't know if it was just the cartoon, if there's a cartoon. I don't know. But I decided to pick it up because I never see it either, so. I went into GameStop the day before to go pre-order Twilight Princess on the Wii U. Also because I wanted to get the Woof Link Amiibo. That's only available if you pre-order Twilight Princess. And they just so happened to have the Amiibo that I have been looking for forever. Which is Charizard. The only reason I'm able to find this now is because this originally was a Target exclusive, I believe. And now they just recently re-released it at GameStop, so now it's available. So go check out your GameStops, they probably have it if you're still looking for Charizard. And then they also came out with some new Fallout 4 pops. So I picked up Hancock. He's one of the companions in Fallout 4. He's pretty cool. Pretty ghoul. yeah, and there's Dogmeat also, but my GameStop said they didn't even see him come in. So I'm going to have to keep my eye out for Dogmeat because I would like to add him as well. Let's see here. So, I went to Toys R Us, and, actually the one in my hometown, and I actually found the Metroid World of Nintendo figure, the 6-inch. This is awesome, because I know the only time I ever saw it out in the wild was at Comic-Con. And they were going, like, I think it was, like, 35, 45, somewhere in between there for this, just because it's not one of the more common ones. I always see Donkey Kong, but I never see anything else. So that was awesome. I don't know if they've, like, recently re-released them, too, or not, but that's one of the, like, the first ones they released, I think. Then when I was in Kansas, I was in Kansas and I stopped at the GameStop there, also found a Jigglypuff, which is, I think they re-released Jigglypuff as well, at GameStop, so that's why I'm able to find her, but, or him, I don't know. I mean, they could be either or, I guess, but... that was the only one I actually saw, and the other GameStops I've gone to since I have not seen Jigglypuff, but I have seen Charizard, so... Also picked up Shovel Knight at GameStop. Haven't seen him here, but I did see him in Kansas, so... Picked that one up. Now, also went to Toys R Us, and I found the 6-inch tall Ganondorf from Wind Waker. And I have the smaller, like, the little figure, but this guy's pretty cool. So, plus I love Zelda, so why not? Right now I'm actually playing through Ocarina of Time. Then I went to Walmart, and don't judge me, but they came out with a new Land Before Time movie. I think this is, like, the 13th one. I have all the other 12. But they used to come out the same time every year, around like December, and then they stopped for, I want to say like 10 years. Maybe, I don't know. But it's got Reba McEntire in it. My mom actually went to college with her. She's actually in her yearbook. It's kind of funny. Yeah, but I'm definitely going to watch that. I've watched all the others, and I love The Land Before Time, even if the new ones, they sing too much, but whatever. Then I went into Game Exchange in Joplin. Was it Joplin? I think it was in Joplin, Missouri. I saw this the first time, and then I left, and I was like, oh, I'm not going to get it. And then went to Vintage Stock and decided that that I was going to go back and get it, because I didn't really see anything at Vintage Stock that I really, really wanted. And I never pass up any Harvest Moon games, so I got Harvest Moon Back to Nature, and I know it was $30. But do you ever see this game? Because I never see, like, any of the older Harvest Moon games, to be honest. So I didn't think $30 was too bad. The only thing, though, that's kind of disappointing is that this cover art is fake. It was actually printed out. If you can see it here. Yeah, it's just paper. Just copy paper. But the disc is fine. I just, now I'm just gonna have to find the actual cover art to this, which may be a little bit of a pain, but I love Harvest Moon. I actually would love to have a complete collection of Harvest Moon. Harvest Moon 64, I spent hours and hours playing it as a kid, so, but the only thing is that the Super Nintendo version is like super expensive, so I think it's like normally like 120, I want to say. I don't know exactly how much it is, but it's really expensive, so I probably won't have any luck with that one anytime soon. And then these are just a few like extra stuff, or actually these were, I don't know if anybody else has, like, a Meijer around them, but it's, like, a grocery store, and it's more in, like, I think it's in, like, Ohio, Wisconsin, Michigan, maybe, and Illinois. I don't know where else it is, but they had some clearance on their games, and unlike Walmart, they actually marked them below $10. Walmart has, like, the worst clearance ever, to be honest. They won't mark anything down lower than 20 usually. But I picked up Zombie U for Wii U because I only have, Mario Kart 8, I think, is the only game I actually have for the Wii U. So now I've got this to play. I've heard okay things about this, so might as well try it out. This one I have heard some pretty bad things about, but Ninja Gaiden 3, Razor's Edge. And yes, I've played other Ninja Gaiden games, so, you know, I'm not going to judge Ninja Gaiden based off of this game. But still, I'd like to play it because I like Ninja Gaiden, so why not? This one also, I already had this game. I actually bought it when it first came out, and actually had the Steelbook edition, but I traded it back in because I got, like, almost all the way through, and I just decided I didn't really like it that much. But I'm going to try it again, and that is Beyond Two Souls. It's $6, so I loved Heavy Rain, which is the same Quantum Dream did Heavy Rain and Beyond Two Souls. And yes, it's Ellen Page, but I don't know. There was just something about it I didn't really like that much, but we'll see. My view on games is kind of changing, though, so there's a lot of games that I didn't used to like that I do now, so. And then this one I was really excited to pick up, but it's Splinter Cell Blacklist. It was $6 on... All of these are brand new, by the way. They're not, like, rewrapped or anything. I love Splinter Cell, and I always kind of got a little upset that they kind of, I think, what was it, Conviction or something, that they, Splinter Cell, he just didn't seem like the stealthy Splinter Cell that he was before. And this one got decent reviews, so I'm going to try this one. And then a couple of pops I picked up also. Not anything like too out of the ordinary, but picked up two Game of Thrones pops. I picked up Dany with her dragon, so that's awesome. And then I picked up Sansa Stark with her dark red hair because it looks good. So, other than that, I really don't have anything else. Got Loot Crate coming. I did cancel Retro Game Treasure, but I think they already charged me unless they refunded me, which I'm not really sure. I'll have to look it up because I actually had it on my credit card, which is why I kind of stopped them, besides the fact that, like, Video Games Monthly was getting better games. But I upped my subscription for Video Games Monthly, so instead of getting 3 games a month, I get 5 games a month. But, you know, I could get 8 because sometimes, most of the time I get like a 2 or 3 up in my box. So it was only like $10 more to up it, so why not? And I don't think I have anything else other than that. So I'll see you guys later.